Another day, another liquor, koppie koffie sê in the morning, another morning well spent in the presence of Jesus. And oh man, just getting the day going, getting ready for the day and doing our thing. I hope you're feeling better. I hope you're doing better. I hope you woke up feeling fantastic. And I hope you start your day off speaking better. That the first words are better ones this morning. Good ones. Strong ones. Ones of life. And I say that this morning because that's in fact what I've been pondering on a little bit. And that is, have you ever realized how easily and how often we end up speaking death over ourselves and over our lives? I'm thinking on this morning, and it seems that like how all illnesses, or at least the ones that I could think of, well, illness in itself is already kind of not a good word, because it describes something that needs fixing or healing or restoration, but how they all have a negative label, a deathly label, in fact. And ever sit and realize how things seem to be popping up like on a daily basis these days for stuff that for stuff that's been around for as long as I can remember. For instance, it's not just ADD and ADHD anymore. There are like 40 million of these different ones these days. Like it's got a subcategory and a sub-subcategory category and sub-sub-sub, and the subs have subs. It's so weird. It's weird. And for me, I feel like it's got to do with the fact that every Tom, Dick and Harry these days wants to be special. Oh, so special. They don't care how special or in what way they are special anymore. Oh, I have a special disease. I am special. That's how far it's gone. Well, that's my perspective on this stuff, at least. The problem with that is that every time you say that word, every time you speak that label, every time you speak that categorized, labeled illness, you are making yourself sicker. You are keeping yourself sick. Or if you weren't, you are making yourself sick. Attention deficit disorder. Well, my God is a God of order, not disorder. So what's that about? Something, something syndrome. Something, something disease. Ugh. It's not nice words. Yeah, but we're just calling it what it is. We're just saying the thing there, man. Stop saying the thing there, man. Because what do we say? Oh, I have this disorder. I have this syndrome. I have this illness. Do you have it now? Oh, dear. I think you might not be realizing that you are busy not only labeling yourself, but busy speaking illness and death over yourself. You're claiming these nasty, terrible things. So the moment you want to dig into the Word of God and look at the promises of God, like Jeremiah 29:11, that says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. But less than 2 minutes after speaking that scripture, you go, I have this disorder and this syndrome and this disease, this illness. So you're just canceling the goodness of God out again by speaking the death over yourself, speaking the illness over yourself, speaking the not lekker goed over yourself. And I understand that these labels and things need to be categorized, I suppose, for the people in the medical field to help them do whatever it is that they do. And I know there are many arguments that make sure, well, that speak against the medical field that are actively making people sicker or keeping them sick, keeping them just healthy enough that they need to come back for more medication. After all, it is businesses, and businesses need to make money. So there are many arguments on that. Anyway, that's for another time, and I don't think I'm remotely smart enough or educated on that enough. I haven't done research on these things to speak on these things, but those are sweating the small stuff for me. The focus of that is what? Anyway, the power of words. I'm pondering on that this morning, and it hit me again differently while I was reading here in John. I started John this morning, and I'm thinking the Bible is also referred to as what? The Word of God. God spoke a word and things happened. He spoke a word and there was life. He spoke a word and there was earth. He spoke a word and there was the animals and there was us. He spoke life and life happened. I think Genesis also, I didn't actually think to go look at Genesis this morning. But he says he breathed his breath of life into man. God's very breath is in us. And then comes in, if we go read this in John 1, and it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. Didn't comprehend this light. It didn't understand this light. Whee! I hope you're getting it. And then coming back to one of my favorite verses, we've had this so often, Proverbs 18:21. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Are in the power of your words, are in the power of word, and those who love it will eat its fruit. You know, it's one of those, as I said, that it just hit me differently this morning. That I knew, that I knew, that I knew, that I know, that I knew, that I know, that I knew, and then God comes and goes, "How's it going, bud? You have a piece of extra life in your word, the living word." Oh man. Caught a piece of Uncle Angus describing the living word of God, because it is the living word. Now we get to read this book that was written some time ago, and it's still so relevant today. The principles are so relevant. The person who the Bible speaks of, the divine person and being. Oh man, it just. Oh, shoo. Anyway, the power of words, because the word of God, because the words are God, according to John 1, verse 1. So the power of the Almighty are in the words that we speak. Considering he breathed his breath into us as for life, our very breathing calls the name of Yahweh. Or YHWH, because there were no vowels back then. But we've added that just to help with pronunciation, the A and the E, I think. The deepest part of our biological design, the laminin, is in the shape of a cross, of a cross resembling Jesus. So everything we are and say, especially say, because it starts with say, has a tremendous effect on us, our lives, and everything around us. Now, I'm not saying these things aren't around, and but I'm just saying that it's like these things keep us in bondage and tries to keep us in bondage. But there are definitely better ways to go about saying them, handling them, and that they don't necessarily form a part of who you are. Because I often tell people, my God don't make no crap. God doesn't make no rubbish. You are created perfectly in his image. And God definitely doesn't have any diseases, syndromes, or disorders, I'll tell you that. He's the God of love. He's the God of life. He is light. There's no darkness in the light. Darkness gets in because we chase the light away. The absence of light brings darkness. I mean, there are many open arguments and hidden agendas and stuff about all the medicines and foods. And just the way that everything and everyone is being babied these days doesn't really help either. It doesn't help. It helps glatty. But God showed me a touch on this when he revealed to me about the bad temper that I used to have. Now, just that term, bad temper, speaks to the fruit of the Holy Spirit, as we touched on yesterday. That I really need to go look at in a nicer way, but the fruit called self-control. You lose your temper when you lose self-control. The emotion overtakes the self-control. But also, that being said, the bad temper side God showed me is a perverted worldly side of tolerance for me. This is what just to give an example. So the fact that I often... used to lose my temper with the way people drive, especially in this town that I live. Oh my word. I just seem to have a zero tolerance level for people who do not only stupid things, but for the selfishness of them, and also for people who break the rules, who break the laws. I don't have a tolerance for people who do that. So I used to lose my temper. Until God slowly brought me to a place where, guys, what do I reach by getting upset with this person not following the rules? There's nothing I can do at that stage. So I just be the example that I try to be. Stay in that space, you know, sort of thing. Anyway, so it's just that the way that it is said. So it's not just that you have a bad temper or had a bad temper. But you don't have a tolerance or a high tolerance or even you might even have a zero tolerance level for that sort of wrong behavior. It's much deeper than that, but I hope it gives you an idea of what I'm trying to say at least. Now, the Bible teaches us to have and use better labels because our identity is not in what the doctor says. Identity is not in what people say. We are not what the doctor says. We are not who the people say we are, and most oftentimes we are not even who we ourselves say we are, especially if it's without Jesus. But it is what and who we can become if we are not careful. It is not who we are, but it is who we can become if we're not careful. So 2 Corinthians 5:17, it has become, but also one of my a very special friend, one of his favorite verses. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. So in Jesus, you are new. There's no illnesses in Jesus. Especially not in terms of identity. Romans 12:2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We had Proverbs 18:21 just now. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, so it is what you speak. Ephesians 2:10, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for what? For good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. So God's already prepared, and we just need to walk in the life side now. So we are new in Jesus. Your identity and life lies in the Word of God and in God himself, because that Word is in us. We need to learn what this is, and we need to start learning to speak life over ourselves, over our situations, over our challenges, over these illnesses and syndromes and disorders. I saw a post some time ago from a well-known doctor who's written books. I'm busy trying to get through one of them still, as I'm learning to be a reader still, or a better reader, in fact. I'm more of an audiobook guy. But anyway, and I saw a post, and this doctor's done books on the neuroplasticity of the mind, where she pretty much describes that the mind is not a piece of computer hardware, that it's just broken when it's broken. No, they show how the brain physically re, I mean, brace, re, new brain cells generate every day, stuff like that, and that you can literally change to recode your mind, recode your brain, recode the way you think, change the way you think completely. It is possible. Like changing the whole operating system on your computer from whatever. And she goes on this post that I saw, she says things like, or she mentions that the problem you have is when you say things like, I am angry. So you are subconsciously adding that anger is a part of what and who you are. It's part of your identity. And then she goes about saying that instead of saying that, we need to learn how to rather say it like, anger is visiting again. So what we're implying is that anger is not a part of what or who we are, and it is in fact an unwelcomed guest. Especially if you say like, oh, anger is visiting again. Ugh. Unwelcome guest. And it's not a part of who we are, and it needs to leave. And through this, we not only learn to understand, but we also learn to exercise the authority and dominion that we have over ourselves, who we and what we are. So learn to speak life into yourself, my friend. Life over yourself, my friend. Life over your so-called illnesses, over your everything. Learn to speak life. The word of God is already in your heart and in your mouth. The word is already in your heart and in your mouth, according to Romans chapter 8, 10, verse 8. And I've seen people healed from all sorts of things just by changing the way they speak. Your words are powerful, my friend. They are very, very powerful. Learn to speak life over every single part of yourself, your life, your situation, who you are. Learn to speak life over these things. Change your labels. Find your label in the Word of God. Shalom, shalom.